So hello guys on the bridge. Welcome all of you to the post-GATE guidance session for GATE 2015. On behalf of GATE Academy, I wish all success to you guys, all successful qualifiers. I wish you all success and may your dream come true in the months to come, and I wish you all success in terms of admissions to the best institutes in India for higher education or in terms of getting jobs in PSUs. We wish you all success. So let's begin quickly with seeing how GATE 15 has been this year, how GATE has gone this year. So few general statistics. Overall, if you see, that is including EC, EEE, IN, CS, including everything, almost 9.8 lakh students have appeared GATE. Overall, 9.8 lakh students have appeared GATE. And the results have been, we have got the results of GATE 15 on March 12th. And we find that the cutoff marks for instrumentation is around 25 for general, around 19 for OBC. This has been the qualifying criteria for instrumentation, and we see that like pretty much we have got openings from IIT for IIT, IISc, or IIT B, IIT M, IIT D, IIT K, IIT KGP, all of them have started announcing the admission notification. I like to draw your attention towards IISc Bangalore, because March, if I recollect correctly, March 18th is the last date, if I recollect correctly. Please, in case you want to apply to IISc Bangalore, log into the website iisc.ernet.in and start applying for your MSc or M.Tech programs. So IISc offers you MSc in engineering and M.Tech in instrumentation. In case you are interested in applying to IISc Bangalore, please start doing it right away, because the date is very, very, very limited. March 18th is the sale of last date for sale of applications, and March 24th is the last date by which your application form should be reaching to IISc. So let us have a broad discussion on how what will be the expectation from IISc. So for M.Tech in instrumentation, it is direct admission. It is direct admission for IISc Bangalore in the course of M.Tech, and your rank should be less than 15 for you to apply for this. Whether you fall under general category or OBC category, your rank should be less than 15. If you fall under other categories, your rank can go up to say 30, not below that. And if you look at IIT and look at MSc program, MSc engineering program, you have interview. It's not direct admission. The admission is based on interview. You will be shortlisted for interview or based on your GATE score, and your GATE score can be up. Your GATE rank can go as low as, you can be less than 300 for you to get a call for interview. Getting a call for interview does not mean you will be getting admission. Your rank, if your rank is less than 300, even then you stand a good chance for getting a call for interview, and your admission will rely totally on the performance of interview. And in IIT Bombay, all these IITs have started giving call for their admissions. They have published the admission notification in their website, and the online application sale has started already. IIT Bombay offers you M.Tech. You don't have MSc programs in IIT Bombay, and all the IIT B programs, you have direct admissions. It's purely based on your GATE score. Your gate score should be less than 30 or say less than 40, you can say, for admission to IIT Bombay. All are based on direct admission. In IIT Bombay, apart from in IISc Bangalore as well as in IIT Bombay, apart from instrumentation courses, you can apply for electronics based courses like EC, M.Tech. I'm sorry. In case of IISc Bangalore, you have ME in electronics, microelectronics. You have M.Tech in electronic system design. For these courses, you can apply. So, for these courses, you can apply in IISc Bangalore. In case of IIT Bombay, you can apply to M.Tech in Control and Computing. You have M.Tech in Microelectronics. These are very, very good branches and you can apply. When I say less than 40 means rank, I am talking about the All India rank. I am talking about the All India rank. For IIT Bombay, the expectation is your All India rank should be less than 40. Okay. And these are the famous courses in IIT Bombay, especially if you are from instrumentation engineering background. Okay. Then you have IIT Madras. In IIT Madras also you have M.Tech. You have Control Systems Engineering here. Also you have electronics, microelectronics basically. I am talking about microelectronics. For IITM as well, your rank should be less than 40. I am talking about AIR. Because IIT Bombay and IIT Madras are among the top IITs. So both the cases in IITM as well as in IITB, it is through direct admission. It is through direct admission. Then we have IIT Delhi, IIT Kanpur and IIT Kharagpur. In these places you have M.Tech in Control, Microelectronics again, and in IIT Kharagpur especially you have a course on Instrumentation Engineering, dedicated Instrumentation Engineering you have. So, for any three of them, your rank can go as low as less than, say you can say less than 75 to 80. If your All India rank is in this order, you stand a very good chance. If your All India rank is in the order of 75 to 80, you stand a very good chance for IIT Delhi, IIT Kanpur and IIT Kharagpur. So, these are the stories with the top rated IIT and IISCs. And of course you have the other top IITs like IIT Guwahati and IIT Roorkee. So few courses in IIT Delhi and IIT Kharagpur is purely based on direct admission. IIT Kanpur, IIT Delhi is mixture of both. It is direct admission plus interview. Few courses are based on direct admission, few courses are based on interview. And the interesting part is, in IIT Madras and IIT Delhi, in both these IITs, you get MS in engineering. You have MS. And for MS, the admission is through written test plus interview after gate. For you to get a call for written test plus interview, your gate score, gate rank, I am saying All India rank, can be less than say around 400. even your rank goes as low as 400, you stand a very good chance, because they look at your GATE score alone does not play a predominant role, because MS is a research based program. You will get a very good chance even your GATE rank is low. They will look mainly for how interest you show in research and other, apart from your GATE score, what you have done in terms of your college project and how is your performance in written test and interview. So written test and interview plays a very crucial role, and especially in interview for MS program in IIT Madras and IIT Delhi, they will test you totally based on what is your research interest and what all your projects done, and in case you have any paper presentations, all these things add value to your MS program. It's purely research based program here. And in case your GATE score goes, GATE rank, what I mean by here is, we are discussing in terms of All India rank always. If your All India rank is in the order of say 100 plus to around 1000, you have a very good chance for IIT Roorkee, IIT Guwahati, and new IITs have come in IIT Hyderabad, IIT, say, you have Bhuvaneshwar, then IIT Roper is there, all these IITs, plus all the top NITs, that is NIT Trichy, NIT Suratkal, NIT Warangal, and then also on top of all these things you have IIT BHU. So if your GATE rank, All India rank is in this order, you have a very good chance for all these places. And especially IIT, NIT Trichy is very, very special, because among all these institutes, only NIT Trichy has a course called Process Control Instrumentation. No other institute is having a Process Control Instrumentation course. NIT Trichy is the only place where you have Process Control Instrumentation, M.Tech, which is very, very famous. It's very good. This course is very good. So if your rank is in the order of this, you stand a very good chance for getting admission into this. And also for MS programs at IIT M and IIT D, your rank is in this order, especially you stand a good chance. And apart from that, if you are looking for PSUs, I will take up your questions. I see a lot of questions coming up. Just give me 2 minutes, I will just brief up and I will take up your questions. So for PSUs, the premium PSUs are Power Grid, you have ONGC, you have the other one is NTPC, and then you have HPCL. All these are the premium PSUs. For all these, if your score, GATE rank, All India rank is anywhere between 100 to 1500, you stand a very good chance. So this is what is the broader picture. I'm not saying these are exact numbers, so this all depends upon the relative mood of the candidates also. So for example, I'm just saying these are all the, it's something like ballpark numbers. I cannot say that your rank is 1525. I have written 100 to 1500 only, so you will not get admission or something like that. It all depends on the mood of the student. Say for example, your rank may be even 30, All India rank 30, but still you may get direct admission in IISc, because top 10 rankers may be opting to go for PSU jobs instead of doing an M.Tech program, or the top ranker is going to US studying abroad or something. So all these things are pretty much, we need to look into the mood as well. So these are not exact numbers. So these are just giving you a broader idea and a broader picture what is going to happen. Now I'd like to take up your questions. So we have a question. I have AIR 269 and I have applied to M.Tech in Instrumentation in Applied Physics. I think when you say M.Tech in Applied Instrumentation and Applied Physics, I think you are talking about IISc Bangalore. So your rank is 269, IISc Bangalore, you have M.Tech Instrumentation direct admission. I think you have a very good scope for MSc Engineering. For 269, Instrumentation becomes, M.Tech in Instrumentation becomes tough. I am sorry, I am not disappointing you here. But you stand a very good chance for MS in engineering under same department. You can apply for instrumentation and applied physics, MSc engineering, or you can even apply for MS in microelectronics or in Department of Electronics and Electronic Systems Engineering in IISc. For the rank of 269, you have a very, very good chance. Apart from that, you can apply for IIT Kharagpur and IIT Kharagpur, you can try. You have a counseling there, you can try for that. And also these IITs you can try. IIT Roorkee, IIT Guwahati, here you stand a very good chance. Score of 784 can fetch me control related branch in which IITs. So fine, your score is 784. Can you tell me what is your All India rank? It will be helpful for me. I think your score is 784. I expect your rank to be around 100 to 200, between 50 to 150, that number. So what is your rank? Somebody has posted your score is 784. I think your rank, yeah, that's what I expected. Rank between 50 to 100, that's what I expected. So your rank is 58. I am sure, since your AIR is 58, I am 100% sure for you to get into IIT Madras, you have a very good chance, and I am sure you will have a very good chance at IIT KGP. And for IIT Bombay, it's difficult. IAR 58 is a bit difficult in case of IIT Bombay. IIT Bombay, but don't hesitate to apply. See, I am sure, guys, let me be very frank to you. For applying to IIT Bombay, the application fees is hardly 500 or 700 rupees. But if you are lucky enough, as I told you, there is no hard and fast rule that you will not get it. I am just working around the chances. Your chance of getting IITM and IIT Kharagpur is very high. That's what I mean. When I say that you have a, if you ask me IISc, I will clearly say no. But regarding IIT Bombay, you stand a decent chance. So don't hesitate from applying to IIT Bombay. But I am sure that about IIT Madras or IIT Kharagpur, definitely in one place you will definitely fit in. There is no doubt about it. And also you stand a very, very good chance. Rather, if you are interested in electronic systems, I will ask you to apply for M.Tech at Department of Electronic Systems Engineering in IISc Bangalore. This is a very, very good place. And that too you will get into IISc. Only thing is there is no direct admission. You will for sure you will get a call for written test and interview. So your performance in written test, your performance in interview, will you can even get into IISc with this score. Only thing is M.Tech, DESC, they will do a written test plus interview. So I will advise you to apply for even IISc course. And MSc in IISc also you have a very, very good chance. With a AAR rank of 58, I am sure that you give a you stand a very, very high chance at IISc Bangalore. I'll say your chance of getting into IISc Bangalore is more than 95% for MS with this score. I got a AAR of 373 and score of 616. In which IIT or NIT can get admission? Fine. AAR 373. So as I said, AAR of 373, you stand a very good chance in all these IITs. And if you are interested, you can even apply to IISc / IITM / IITD for MS programs. You have a very, very good chance here. Only thing is, it's a research-based program. If you are really having a research-based mindset, you will be doing some really, really very, very good, very quality research you will be doing here. And you will be learning a lot, and the value added. See, one thing I will tell you guys, many students I have seen, they will think that MS means job opportunity is bad, M.Tech means in India job opportunity is very good. I will tell you, this is nothing like, I think people will have a mindset like this, M.Tech means very good job opportunity, MS in India means very bad. There is nothing like that. Please, I will tell you, M.Tech and MS in India are having the equal market value. Say for example, in case of IIT or any place where you do MS, when they come for campus interview, they will never say that, no, I want only M.Tech student, I want only MSc student, nothing like that. As long as your performance is very good, the companies which is coming for campus interview will definitely be interested in MS students as well as M.Tech students, both. Both of them have the equal amount of job opportunities. So don't even feel that MS is a bad course in India or something like that. Those are all rumors. And that too, see, MS, doing MS at some local colleges, definitely it is going to be very bad because the colleges will not have very good research facilities or something like that. Whereas if you are going to do at IISc, IITM or IIT Delhi, which are rated on par in, what to say, on par with the international standards, definitely your MS program will be very, very valuable. So if you are having an AAR of 373 or any AAR in the range of less than 400, for whom, so I see a couple of questions also. If your AAR is less than 400 and you are really having a research mindset, please do apply to these programs. You will definitely get a call. And it is your performance in interview which will convert this call into a confirmed admission, or you may get rejected depending upon your performance at interview. But you have a very, very good chance for doing MS from IISc or IITM or IIT Delhi. So don't miss that chance. Of course, if you are saying that no, I don't want to do MS, I want to do only M.Tech, definitely you stand a very good chance, but not at these places. You will get into NIT Trichy or NIT Suratkal or NIT Warangal or any of these IITs. IIT BHU is also a very good option. You can try in all these places. You stand a very good chance. But my personal advice to you guys will be, wherever you study here, IISc, IITM, IITD, the life here is totally different compared to all these places. So you can get, when you have a chance to get into the best, why to compromise for good is what I'm trying to say. You have a chance for the best. My personal advice is, you apply to both of them. You apply to this program as well as this program. Let's see how to take it further. You have a very good chance at both these. My gate score is 340 and my AAR is 2470. So AAR of 2470, well, I'm sorry, unless and otherwise you have some reservation with you, it's very difficult for you. But you stand a good chance. Even in case of NIT Trichy, NIT Suratkal, NIT Warangal, I doubt NIT 2000, any rank, my personal experience, any rank more than 1800, life becomes little difficult to get into these top NITs. Top NITs, NIT Suratkal, NIT Trichy, NIT Warangal, these are the three top NITs. Life becomes little difficult to get into this. Yeah, if you have a very good, if you have reservation, then you stand a good chance here. Okay, if you have reservation, you stand a good chance here. I'll say that the chance for you to get into NIT Trichy, Suratkal, Warangal will be almost 80%. I'll give you 80% chance. You have an 80% chance of getting into it if you have a reservation. If you don't have a reservation, well, general and OBC are pretty much same. General and OBC, the margins are pretty much, there is no much big difference here. So if you are from general or OBC, your chance will be less than 50%. If your any rank is greater than 1800, to get into top 3 NITs. If you want to get into NIT, say NIT Allahabad or NIT Roorkela, all these things, you have a good chance. There are, other than this also, there are so many NITs. I am just rubbing this out. There are so many NITs. Like you have NIT Roorkela. You have NIT Kurukshetra. You have NIT Jalandhar. Okay, and also you have, these colleges, you stand good chance. You can try applying these colleges. Yeah, okay, I see one more question. AAR of rank 469. Okay, which IIT/NIT AIR of rank 469. I will say that IIT, it's difficult. All the top IITs, but you can try in ITBHU. IITs are difficult. You can try in ITBHU. When I mean IIT, I am talking about IIT, Bombay, Delhi, Kharagpur, Kanpur, all these IITs. You have also these new IITs coming up, which are nowhere lesser, which are nowhere, because since these are new, the competition here is little bit less. That is the only reason. You have IIT Hyderabad, you have IIT Bhuvaneshwar, you have IIT Roper. So these places you have a good chance. NIT Trichy, Warangal, Suratkal, these places your chances are almost, here your chance is greater than 90% to get admission for AIR of 469. NIT Trichy placement opportunities for any branch, NIT Trichy, Warangal, I will tell you, and Suratkal, all these three NITs, placement opportunity for all the courses are very good. NIT Trichy, Warangal, Suratkal, your placement opportunities are very, very good. Placement is under, I can say that, well, to be very honest, say, placement will be more than 95%. By the time you are in your third semester to fourth semester, almost, say, 100 students are there, means definitely 90 to 95 students will get placed. So placement wise, you have a very good chance for all the courses at NIT Trichy, Warangal and Suratkal. So, yeah, you will get core placement. See, okay, one thing I will tell you, if you consider NITs for M.Tech, core placement, suppose if you take core, suppose if you are in control or electronics or instrumentation based course you are selecting, your core based placement will be almost 70%. Remaining 30% will be software based placement, software slash miscellaneous. This is how the breakup is in generally, the general tendency I am telling you. And this is the fair enough, this is the fair enough breakup that happens pretty much. So rather I will say that this number is around 60 to 70, and this is around 30 to 40%, to be very honest. But definitely, because of your M.Tech, you land up, your placement value goes up. And see, if your AAR is 672, IIT again, as I said, IIT, any IIT becomes, see, greater than 500. Any IIT becomes difficult. I am not saying a hard no, but your chances drops down to less than 20% if your rank is more than 500. But your chance for PSU slash NITs are greater than 70%. 70, rather I will say 80%. This is what is the this is what is my experience telling me, because I am into gate coaching for almost past 5 to 6 years, and I have seen, this is the trend we have seen. So AIR of 1605, well, definitely gate score adds you, gate score gates you, adds value to you, but When your gate score goes beyond 1000, well, chances, I will say it's 40-60, yes versus no. See, that's what I'm saying. Any rank greater than, I have already given answer. If your rank is 650, what is your chance? This is what I will tell you. Whether you are in general or OBC category, pretty much the picture is almost same. The ranks will differ by plus or minus 20 between general and OBC. It will not jump from 0, rank 1 to rank 100. So the rank will differ by plus or minus 20. Say, for example, if this number, if this is greater than 480 for general, it will be greater than 500 for OBC, something like that. Your ranks will not jump from haywire from here to there. So this is what it is. So if your rank is 269, I think I already answered you. Rank is 269, you stand a very, very good chance for IISc / IITM / IITD MS programs. Otherwise also you stand very good chances for M.Tech at IIT Hyderabad, IIT BHU, NIT Trichy, IIT Roper, all these places. All these places. And PSU, very, very high chance. Well, which PSU is little bit tougher question for me. So again, that's what I'm saying to say. Rank of, see, you can compare with a rank of great. So if your rank is anywhere around less than 600, you will get premium PSUs. That is something like Power Grid, the top paying PSUs you will get. Power Grid or ONGC, BPCL, HPCL, I don't know. Okay. You will get a very good chance. Say if it is between 600 to 800, you will get the next category of PSUs. Greater than 1000, again the next category of PSUs. This is what it happens. Your rank and score are interrelated, right? Okay. Whether you will get a call based on rank, or you will get a call based on score. Your rank and score are in turn interrelated, right? So, if you look at the formula they are calculating, your rank and score are interrelated. One is a function of other. So, that's what. So, it's one and the same. Yeah, I understand. Rank and score are pretty much one and the same. That's what I'm trying to say. Your rank is derived from your score. So if you calculate back, your score can be derived back from rank also. So this is one and the same. Definitely your rank will start jumping by more than 20 ranks within a score of 2 or 3. See, if you look at the curve, there will be pretty much as your score drops down, the crowd starts increasing more and more, more and more. Yeah, see, you, for with respect to private sector, see, for public sector, let me elaborate this. For public sector, GATE is mandatory. Okay. Let me clear up the board. For PSU, GATE is compulsory nowadays. For private, GATE is added advantage. So what I mean to say is, you can apply to PSU without a GATE score, you cannot apply at all. If you have cleared GATE and you have a valid GATE score, then only you can apply to PSU. Otherwise, you cannot apply to PSU. Whereas in case of a private sector, even without GATE score, you can apply. But GATE becomes a distinguishing factor. So GATE will tell you how much core competence you are having. In case of your GATE score, if you are having a very good GATE score, it directly boils down to your core competence. So GATE score in case of a private sector is an added advantage. Say for example, if I have to select between candidates who, and I am interviewing them and I am finding them, and one is GATE qualified and other people are not GATE qualified, I will prefer a GATE candidate. But it is not that purely based on GATE score you will start applying to PSUs, I am sorry, private sectors. GATE score is not mandatory, it is an added advantage there. It gives you an edge over the others who are competing with you. So NIT TRICHIP process control, that's what I told you, right? In case of process control, NIT TRICHIP, lot of good companies come and recruit. Like one of the famous recruiter is Yokogawa, Siemens, then Allen ABB, Allen Bradley. I have seen these people recruiting from NIT Trichy. I have seen one of my own friend is working in Yokogawa, is from, he did his M.Tech from process control only. My own friend. So you have very good chances for getting admission, getting a placement call from these places. But again, these people, they do not, what to say, like, you have a very, very good chance of getting recruited here. But there is no guarantee tomorrow there is no guarantee that they will be coming back to back for recruitment. From process control point of view, since NIT Trichy is the only place where process control instrumentation, directly a course named process control instrumentation, is being offered as an M.Tech, your placement chances in core company is very, very good. These people alternately, they come every alternate years, and one of them, definitely at least one of them or two of them visits every year. That's what I can say. At least two of them will visit every year. AIR 994 PSUs. Fine. Again, my say will be premium PSUs. My say will be yes. AIR of 672, NITT, process control instrumentation, fine. This is what I will say. Because process control instrumentation is the only, as I told you, right, this process control instrumentation, only place where you get offered in whole India is only NIT Trichy. M.Tech, I am talking about the good colleges. Lot of private colleges also offer process control instrumentation. I am talking about the premium colleges in India who offers these courses. Of that, only NIT Trichy has this course. So for this course, your chance is 50-50. If you are trying for other courses, you may stand a higher chance. But for 672, the chances are really fair enough, I'll say. Rather, it may be, even I can give you a 60-40 chance as well. This may be the same. Because the reason being, many of the people may have a mindset to go into PSUs also. Well, AAR of 84, space science, I will say you stand a chance of more than 90%. If your rank is 84, if you want to get into Institute of Space Science and Technology, you have a chance. I will rather say that why can't you try for IIT, say you can, with AAR of 84, you stand a good chance for IIT Kharagpur, IIT, IIT BHU. You can also apply here. IIT B M.Tech with AAR of 84, IIT B M.Tech. This will be the chance you will get. IITB is very difficult with 84. In IN, because in what happens is instrumentation, the number of seats available for instrumentation students are less. So if you have a AAR of 84 in case of EC or EEE, it's, I'll say it's 100% chance. But IITB, you want to get with AAR of 84 in instrumentation, it becomes 5 to 95% chance of yes versus no. You have a good chance in IIT Kharagpur and IIT BHU. IIT Roorkee also, I can say, you have a very good chance. Space science, I will give you a chance of more than 90%. And if you want to get into premium PSUs like Power Grid, NTPC, BP, all oil companies, you have a chance again here also of more than 90% with an AAR of 84. AAR 680, as I said, any AAR of greater than 500, all IITs become difficult. Especially IIT B, it's very, very difficult. It's very difficult. NIT Hamirpur. See, all the NITs have a tag value for NIT. So, the fact that NIT Hamirpur is a NIT is good. But personally, I feel that you should try for NITT, Warangal, Suratkal. If you don't stand a chance here, you should try for, my preference will be like this, Rourkela, Kurukshetra, Jalandhar, and then Allahabad, then other then all the other NITs come, then only all the other NITs. So if your rank is 672, I am sure you should be able to get into somewhere here. I believe, check Kurukshetra, Jalandhar, you should be able to get into. Yeah, and okay, this year Power Grid is not recruiting instrumentation. I am just giving you a overall idea. If you are looking, especially talking about this year, yes, Power Grid is not recruiting instrumentation this year, but these people are recruiting instrumentation, you stand a good chance. That's what I mean to say. AIR of 940. What is your AIR? Sorry, AIR of 994. Sorry, AIR 994. So you want to get into NALCO. Well, I'm sorry, I'll give a 40-60 chance. You stand a decent chance, that's what I can say. Applying into it, stand good chance. Yep. My answer would be this. Try, see, since your rank, see guys, any rank up to 1000, any rank up to 1000, see what happens basically is these are the ranges where you see more crowd there in pretty much multiple places. So it becomes somewhat a tough situation to give a tough call to say 100% yes or a no. So it is something like you have to wait. So if your rank is in this order, anything above 800, all these things, you have to really, that's what I'm trying to say is all these ranks, 670, 600, 700, 800, 900, all these ranks, all these ranks above 600 to 1000, that range, especially as your rank goes in the order of 800, 900, the crowd amount of people will be more. So, your chance starts dropping down. So, as you are approaching towards 1000, your chances are less. You are approaching towards 500, chances increases. That's what I can say for PSUs. If your rank is between 300 to 600, chances of PSUs are very good. 300 to 600, 600, 700 range, chances of PSUs are very good. Yep. Next question, please. See, if your rank is around 600, okay, I think the same question is pretty much coming again and again. Let me give you a broad idea what happens actually. See, for example, let us take some institute, say for example, IIT Bombay, for example. So, IIT Bombay has a course called, I am just giving you example, okay. This is example. So it is having a M.Tech in say control. Okay, I am just giving you a broader idea. Say it is having 30 seats. What actually happens is, of these 30 seats, for these 30 seats, EC fellow will be competing, Triple E fellow will be competing, Instrumentation fellow will be competing. Then, after that, they will have sponsors. Sponsors will be from some companies / colleges. Here you don't need gate at all. And you don't get, for sponsors, if you are doing M.Tech through sponsorship, you will not get campus placements also. Here you don't need gate, no placement also. Because you are being sponsored by some other company, you will not get placement also. Okay, so what happens is, of these 30 seats, some 3 seats will go for sponsorship. Remaining 27 seats are available. Now of this, general, OBC and reservation, miscellaneous, what to say, you'll have SC, ST, physically handicapped, all these reservations will come into picture. So roughly you see, you will have some three seats here, remaining is 21, so roughly you will get around 10 and 10 seats here, something like this, something around this. I'm sorry, this will be around, let us make this as also 16, so this adds up to 32, let us make this as 35. So this is how the breakup will be. General, I am giving you a broad idea. Of these 16 seats, 6 seats will be available for EC, 6 seats for IN, EEE, and 4 seats for IN. This is how they will allocate. Something like this, this much calculation will happen at the back side. So, if you are rank 4, that means literally, theoretically speaking, this is only for one course. Like this, every IIT may have, you may stand chances for say 4 courses. Suppose if I consider this as IISc Bangalore, for example, say for you are eligible for 4 courses, that means rank top 4 will go here, next 4 will go here, next. That means in 4 courses, 16 ranks will be consumed. Okay, this is the basis on which I am giving you data. 16 ranks, all AAR 1 to 16, I am just giving you some example. We'll get into IISc Bangalore. But what will happen is, not everybody may be interested in control. Say for example, AAR rank 5 fellow is there. He is getting into this course. There is another course called, for example I am saying, there is another course called Instrumentation. He is getting into this, but he wanted control. He is not getting in IISc Bangalore, but he is getting in IIT Bombay controls. For example, I am giving you an example, okay. So, say AAR 5 is there, he is not getting in IISc Bangalore, but he is getting a desired branch in IIT B control. He will go into this. He will not prefer this. That is the reason I told you, if you want to get into IIT Bombay or IISc Bangalore M.Tech program, ME or M.Tech program, your rank has to be less than 30. If your rank is less than 30, somewhere you will get matched and you will get admission. Based on this is what I was telling. After people will definitely prefer this. After this people will prefer IIT Madras. After this people will prefer IIT Delhi. After this it will be Kanpur, Kharagpur. After this all the other IITs which are newly opened, IIT BHU, all these things will come into picture. After that you will have NITs getting filled up. In between IIT and NIT you will have PSUs also getting filled up. This is a general tendency. Okay, if you look at say for example last year, one of the fellow who was having an AAR rank of 20 or something, he got admission into IIT as well. He got admission into IIT Delhi as well as he got admission into one of the PSU. He got selected in PSU. His mindset was to get into a government job. So he preferred to go to a PSU instead of going into IIT Delhi. So these are all mindset of people. So that emotion factor of everybody, how every individual is thinking also will come into picture. So I can give you a broad, based on this calculation, if you do a hand calculation based on this, you will find that all the IIT seats will be getting filled up for rank less than say 200 to 250. All the IIT seats will be filled up. Again, but there are PSUs, there are MS programs. So coming and pulling out students from here. That is the reason this number goes to less than 300 or 350. Now new IITs have come. IIT Bhuvaneshwar, IIT Roper, IIT Hyderabad, all these things have come. Hence this number is further jumping to 450. That is the reason I was giving you these numbers. Now again, somebody will say that, again these are all emotion driven. People will think that, no, IIT Hyderabad is a very new institute, whereas NIT Trichy is 50 year old institute. instead of going to IIT Hyderabad, I will go into NIT Trichy. Though it is NIT, it is 50 year old and it has more value. Again, these are all mindset of people and some emotion factors behind that. So because of which, all these things happen, these variations happen. And some people will say that, no, NIT, instead of getting into a course at NIT Trichy, I will like to take a job in PSU, life gets settled. See, again, these are all decisions defined by individual likes and dislikes. So based on that likes and dislikes, your chance gets varied. So if you are in the rank, say for example, if you are in the rank of 600, there are 599 people before you. How these 599 people are going to think will affect your chances. That is what I was trying to say. Based on that only, say majority of these 599 people are saying that, say for example, in a worst case, all these 599 people are saying that I will not take admission into IIT or IISc. All these 599 people decide to go into PSUs only. Then the rank 600 will go into IISc itself. So, but the probability for that is very, very low. So based on that only, I was giving you a chance of 20% yes, 80% no, 50% yes, 50% no, all those things. This is the, the judgment behind that. Clear? Okay guys, we are coming to the conclusion of this. On behalf of Gate Academy, I wish you all success and I want you guys, all of you, to get placed into good PSUs and get into good IISCs and IISCs and IITs and do a successful course. Wish you all success guys. All the best.